Welcome to this brief guide on how to use the side panel in Google Chrome. A substantial percentage of the world use Google Chrome as their primary browser, but few know about the newly released side panel feature. And so today, I wanted to walk you through how to activate and use this feature that can help make your browsing experience more effective than ever. Here I have my Google Chrome start page, and to activate the side panel, I use the new side panel icon in the top right that will be sitting beside your profile picture. And this will open the side panel and shift your browsing window over a little to accommodate it. And if you wish to adjust the size of the side panel, you can do so using the handle. Simply click and drag to resize it. At the moment, you can see that it is showing the reading list feature, but we can use the drop-down arrow here to see the other options available to us. We have options for bookmarks, history, reading mode, and more. We can even use the customize Chrome option to adjust the appearance of our browser if we'd like. This gives us a super fast way to adjust between modes like dark mode and light mode, or the option to follow our device theme. And we can also adjust the color of our Chrome window using the selections found below here. I think I'll stick with the blue accent for now. And to close the side panel down, we simply click on the X icon in the top right corner. And now let's see the side panel in action during a regular browsing session. In this example, I've been looking over this article from The Verge all about Marvel's What If Season 2. And I'll open up my side panel using the button just like before. The reading list is a tool that you can use to collate websites to come back to read in the future without needing to either leave the tab open or create additional bookmarks on your profile. To add this site, I simply click the Add Current Tab button. And in order to go to any of these sites in my reading list later, I just have to click on the site in the reading list. And once I am done with it, I can mark it off as read using the tick icon found here. And you'll see that Chrome notes that I have now read this page. And so if I want to remove the item from my reading list, I can use the X icon that shows when I hover over the item in my list. Next up, we move over to our bookmarks section. This is pretty self-explanatory, but here you can quickly access any existing bookmarks that you have saved. And the same thing with regards to the next option, which will let you see your browsing history in order to quickly get back to any sites that you've previously visited. There's even a search bar to make finding that particular site as easy as possible. The next one is a favorite of mine, the reading mode option. It allows you to view the content of the site without all of the graphics and images. And you can even highlight text inside the side panel and see it highlighted on the website for you at the same time. This can make finding and copying a quote from a website so much easier. The reading mode also has the ability to adjust things like its font type and size, which can make reading easier for many. You can also change the color scheme to an option that meets your needs better. Same with options like line spacing and letter spacing. And last, but certainly not least, we have the search option. This is one that I think many will grow to use a lot as it is extremely useful. The search panel features a few items as soon as I open it, including some potential searches related to the content of the site that I'm currently on. And below there, we have some details about the site source itself. Using the More About This Page option will give me some detailed information about the site, including things like Trustpilot reviews. The search pane is not just limited to the usual text searches either. Using the lens icon, I can upload an image to search, or I can use the option here to select any area of the page to search for. For example, if I want to search for this image, but just the part with Captain Carter, I can do so. And my search has found images just like my snipped image, as well as other images of Captain Carter in What If. And heading back to the main search page, we can show what a text search looks like. I'll just use one of these related searches here by clicking on it, and we can see a search results page very similar to a regular Google search. It includes links to the Wikipedia and IMDb pages as I would expect it to. Selecting the IMDb link will open the result in a new tab automatically for me, whilst also updating the side panel here with new related searches based on this new page's content. And when I finish with it, I can close the side panel with that X icon in the top corner, just like we did earlier. And that is how you use the new Google Chrome side panel to make browsing the web easier, more efficient, and more accessible than ever before. I hope you found this tip extremely useful and it saves you plenty of time in the future, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.